I decided to stop straightening my hair 2 to 3 times a week and transition into being natural. The problem is that I don't really know what I'm doing. I'm really just making this video to show you guys what I did. Today was the first time that I actually had time to sit and experiment. My goal was not to have a bunch of different steps and use a bunch of different products, because as a single mom who is really busy most of the time, I'm always playing beat the clock. So my life is not set up like that. I normally have a little bit of time to get myself and my son ready, and then we're running out of the door. My goal was just to find one product that I could use after I wash and condition my hair and let it air dry. I did use a diffuser in this video just to see what it would do, but honestly, I got tired of standing there diffusing my hair. Like, you know, this is taking a really long time. I gave up on diffusing and I just let it air dry. And this is what happened. Anyway, enough of me talking. I want you to see exactly what I did.
And I used this little brush that I got from Target. It feels really good on my hair. Like when I comb it out in the shower with conditioner in it, it doesn't pull. It runs through my hair really smooth. Shampoo and conditioner. This brand, I just like it because it smells good, really. I don't really have a real reason for using it other than it smells good, it feels good on my hair. I ordered this travel diffuser. So it opens up and then it collapses. Supposed to fit on any blow dryer. I have to cheat a little bit on my curl pattern. So the ends of my hair, maybe about that much, still dry straight. I don't know what size they are. Apparently they come, the sizes go by the color. So I just bought a bunch of these and I'm just gonna have to cheat and curl the bottom parts of my hair. Hopefully get it to match the rest of my curl pattern, which is gonna be kind of hard because my hair doesn't really coil. Like what this will do to my hair, it kind of just waves really hard, if that makes sense. I don't know, I'm just filming this and I'm gonna see what happens at the end. So we'll both be surprised.
So I'm just starting off with some towel dried hair. Just gonna part it down the middle using this wide tooth comb to get all of the kinks out. I like using the wide tooth comb because it doesn't like rip my hair out if it is tangled. So I'm just gonna do this on both sides. Here I'm just using my nails to section it off. Using small portions because I need everything to be coated in the product. Here, I just want you to see that the product is from the root to the tip. And I'm using this rat tail comb because I need each strand of my hair to be coated in the product. I don't want like some bushy pieces and others aren't bushy. I need everything to blend as much as possible, especially since I got these damaged ends. I don't need anything else to not blend. I'm already having enough trouble blending the straight pieces in my hair. So this rat tail comb is just helping me spread it out evenly. So some pieces are kind of sticking together a little bit, and not clumps, I don't want to use that word, but as you can see, like this piece here in my hand is a little too big for me. So I'm just separating some of the strands of hair so that they can dry curly on their own. Like I don't want a bunch of hair to dry together, if that makes sense. Still separating pieces. I didn't go as far as like one strand, two strand, three strand. I didn't go that far, but I'm just trying to pull those pieces apart. Still checking for big patches of hair that are stuck together. So by the time I got done doing the right side of my hair, the left side had kind of dried a little bit. So I'm just taking this spray bottle with nothing but water in it. No leave-in conditioner, nothing like that. Just
water to wet it down. I combed it out, and now I'm up to the front of my hair where I have straight pieces from flat ironing so much. And I probably should have used some of those small top papers on the ends just to hold the ends of my hair to the perm rod, but as you can see, I kind of struggled with this a little bit, but I finally got them in there, and I'm trying to roll them loosely. I did a terrible job at this, but I tried my best. Time to diffuse now. So I'm doing what I saw in my research, and a lot of young ladies diffuse their hair like this. They push it upward. They don't rake through the curls, of course. But, I mean, for whatever reason, this just wasn't working out for me the way that I saw it. So, I just really got irritated. You can see here, like, my patience went out the window at this point. This silicone diffuser ended up being kind of a waste of money. So, I'm done with that. And I was just ready to get out of that bathroom. I had been in there so long.
Again, I have no idea what I'm doing. I did spray a little bit of this in it. This is some olive oil that I would use on my hair when I was straightening it because it wasn't heavy and it doesn't weigh my hair down. I think it's adding shine. I'm not really sure if it is, but I use that at the end too. But like, subscribe. Thanks for watching this video. I'll see you guys in the next one.